dando natura finisce di creare le sue spezie, l'uomo quindi comincia a creare le sue stesse. Se qualcuno vuole tradurre in English, anyone wants to translate in English? I will start this talk with what are our basic assumptions about arts, technology, and complexity. First is, for us, art cannot exist under a certain threshold of complexity in the creative process. Second is, computer technology may help us to elicit this threshold, to elicit to experiment, in fact, this threshold, by building artifact and by able to observe what happens in the interaction with this artifact. It is an experimental theater to experiment this idea. And third, in this talk and in our laboratory, we understand complexity in the meaning of complex systems. The definition of complexity could be very large, but that is our entry in this question. We started our research in 1977 and in computer music, computer animation, and more recently in choreographic arts. And what we choose to address this question is by means of physically based optical modeling and simulation systems and force feedback physically based interactions. And by this means, our prospects, in fact, is to be able to go toward a unified way to create with music animation with hear, vision, and body, and to define, to go toward what we call the dynamic instrumental arts. In a general way, not in a separate way, music in one hand, animation or dynamic art in another, dynamic visual arts in another one, a choreographic art, but a kind of common concept with all this. And we think that this approach, physically based approach and physical interaction, is one of the, it is right, but one of the best candidates to go toward this aim. During all this year, we developed a complete modeling physically based particle system called Cordis-Anima, and we developed our own force feedback devices technology called ACROE-ICA. And we used this to design computer models of a wide variety of dynamic systems, to simulate them in real time, to interact physically with them, and to feel their sensible behaviors, whatever the senses that is addressed, auditory, visual, and physical or tactile, in a unified way, not only in a separate way. Why did we choose these principles that seem very specific? And why did we develop these technologies? First of all, about physically based particle modeling system. Differently of what it is usually considered, we don't choose physical modeling for its realistic properties. In computer graphics, for example, physical modeling is used to be able to produce realistic motions. But if we understood the term physical modeling in a large meaning than usual, that is only the modeling of physics meaning nature, but as a general system of representation, of course also of natural phenomena, but not only, it is for us the best candidate to model and simulate complex computer dynamic systems. What is complex computer dynamic systems? They are systems that are able to exhibit complex dynamic behaviors in all the range of the sensible phenomena, auditory, visual, tactile, and physical. And thus, these techniques or this method of representation of modeling can be positioned positively among other modeling systems, agent network based, neural network based, cellular automata based, etc. If we have time, we can discuss on it. It could be an interesting discussion for us. to allow the human instrumentalist or the human user to feel the natural objects and the digital world. Feeling is not the most important thing in itself. When we see the world, we don't feel what has happened in our retina. We recognize the world and we act on the world. It is only a means, only a way, not a finality. Thus, we use the force feedback interaction to allow the user, to allow the instrumentalist, in fact, to be dynamically connected to, for example, the natural object and the computer model. That is for us a necessary condition to improve the richness and the quality of the produced sensible phenomena. This means that the technological requirements of such technologies have to exhibit sufficient quality or the necessary quality to ground the complexity of the dynamic grouping between human and physical object, between human and simulated nature, to take your word. And third, about arts, complexity and technology, as I said in my second slide, we assume that artistic process and artistic appraisal cannot be triggered under a certain threshold of complexity in the production and the creative process, not in the produced event, as said by Pompey, but in the creative process itself. This means that the complication or the simplicity of the produced sensible phenomena or events are not sufficient to work out criteria for these processes and appraisal. And what it happens in the production process, in the creative process in itself, is engraved more or less explicitly in the produced sensible phenomena. And then it plays a critical role in the artistic process and artistic appraisal. We focus not on the produced event, but on the process that produced the event. And we assume that what we feel with our senses is not the sensible phenomena, but the process, the creation processing ground in this produced final sensible phenomena. In this way, this means that sounds, images, and so on are not phenomena appreciated by in itself, but representation of the creative process. For example, representation of the interaction between the human and his instruments, or the human and the nature. That is this displacement, that is the foundation of our research program. What is the domain of validity of this basic assumption? Probably not from the domain of the world, but we are sure that this assumption could be valid in the domain of what I call the instrumental dynamic arts. What are instrumental dynamic arts? They are arts based on temporal evolving events, arts based on sensible phenomena produced by a physical object, that is for us synonymous, because when events are evolving in time, they need obviously to be produced by more or less a physical object. For example, sound are necessarily produced by inertial and elastic matter. Sound does not exist without matter. Sounds cannot be produced by nothing. Visual motion are necessarily produced by inertial and rheological matter. And they are the response of the matter to an external or internal action. So thus art, the dynamic arts, or instrumental arts are arts based on sensible phenomena produced by a physical object. And this physical object become an instrument because to produce this phenomena, this object has to be played explicitly or not, internally or not. And that is, dynamic instrumental arts are, for example, musical arts, dynamic or kinematic visual arts, or choreographic arts. Thus, we can generalizing the musical works, we can call the physical object an instrument, the player, whatever it is, a human or another object, in fact, an instrumentalist. And what it happens during this instrumental interaction? When you play the cello, when you rub the surface, when you move the past, etc., and when you most unpredictable emergent effects, such as the music, paragraph changing, sticking, cracking, breaking, etc. State changing, etc. Transition, presence. This means that we can represent this interaction by two blocks, simple blocks that represent the human as an active learning system, and the square blocks that represent the physical object as more or less passive dynamic systems. And these two are in closed loop dynamic grouping, always. And what it means? It means that the human acts as an instrumentalist, and this means that instrumentalist is always playing with chaos, trying to master it with more or less success or failure. On the opposite side, on the side of the instrument, this means that the produced sensible phenomenon engraves more or less explicitly this world. And it is a sensible representation of this complex relationship. And between both, this means that the instrumental dynamic situation can be seen as a representation of our complex closed-loop relation to the physical world. A representation of the relation between human and nature in a general way. That is a kind of mock-up. When Rostropovich played the cello, perhaps suddenly he plays very, very nicely, but what is very important, we think, it is that in this situation, it is a kind of mock-up of our general relation between us and the physical world of the nature. For us, it is very important. I will try to illustrate these assumptions through typical examples, the finger on the glass, the cello effects, dunes, and sound effects. All these examples have been developed in our laboratory with the techniques I call the at the beginning of my talk. Instrumental, visual, and auditory cooperation, scale cooperation in music, microscale and macroscale, wide effect, multisensory representation of nanoscale phenomena in science and also in physics. First example, finger on glass. For us, it is our mascot example. It is our mascot example because when we are rubbing a crystal glass with a wet finger, the sound produced is very simple. Very pure. More pure is the crystal, more perfect is the shape, more simple is the sound. With one note, vibrating a signal with one or two modes, vibrating modes. Thus, there is a mystery. Why does it look marvelous? Why are we looking enviously to Fran, who is able to perform this? Why we are not able to perform this? Well, we are not happy when we don't success. It is a trivial situation, but for us it is the starting of the artistic instrumental situation. It's not important. Why? Because the finger glass system is typically a complex system able to produce an unpredictable emergent effect, very simple. Patience, purifications, stability, patience, patience. The sound can appear or not. Camera can change or not. And this means that all these effects cannot relate simply to only parameters control, as it is done today in synthesizer, in computer music synthesizer. The intensity of the sound is not directly correlated only to the pressure force, for example, or to the finger velocity. When the sound, it is well known that when the sound is started, then we can sustain it even if we relax the pressure, or if we decrease the velocity, etc. And they are typical complex effects. This is the same in a cello playing. It is exactly what it happened when we play cello. And the difference between Rostropovich and myself is that Rostropovich knows to play with such chaos, relaxing the pressure, increasing or decreasing the velocity of the bow at the right state, not at the right moment, but at the right state of this complex dynamic system. And I am not able to do this. For example, Rostropovich is able to change the direction of the bow, the change with high velocity, velocity zero, and changing the sense of the direction of the bow, exactly continuum of this deformation without less of vibrating energy. And you don't hear the changing. When I play cello, you hear the changing. Okay. This means that the gesture of Rostropovich is at the scale of the free vibration, the auditory vibration. That is a mystery, because normally the body, the physical body, does not feel this frequency. This means that this phenomena cannot be obtained with open loop model in which there is, such as presented here, in which there is no dynamic coupling and no energetic consistency between the acted part here and the sounding part here, as when the acted part are linked with the sounding part with an electric current. And it is what is modeled nowadays in our technological tools, in our computer, musical synthesizer. In a musical synthesizer that are mainly based on the mapping concept, we have on one hand a parameter control part. For example, we sense the data from the hand with sensors. And in another part, we have the production sound part that produces the sound. And between both, we have a control paradigm. The first control the parameter of the signal. For example, the hand, with the hand, we are able to control the pitch, for example, the pitch of the sound. But you see that here, the arrow are unilateral arrow. They are not the system. And with this type of implementation, it is not possible to obtain what I said before, the finger on the glass effect. To model the finger on the glass effect, we have necessarily to model this by means of two dynamic coupled systems that cannot dynamically separate. This means that we have to implement in computer this type of loop. And this means that all the from the hand to the ear have to be computed at the acoustical frequency. That is not possible nowadays by the computer. Not only by the computer, but also by the system manipulated by that. Because it is too much computer consuming, but not only computer consuming. But this means that the reactivity, that is for us the master world, the reactivity of the loop has to be normally, at the acoustical scale. This means that we have to simplify this chain and to render feasible this implementation. We have to model the physical object in several parts. But what we have to take into account and what we have to be aware is that these parts must have to be always in bilateral dynamic coupling. For example, if we cut the end chain in two parts, one devoted to special features and low frequency force feedback coupling, the frequency, for example, 1, 2, 3, 5 kHz, and the second to the dynamic features with high frequency, 44 kHz, 40 kHz for the sound for the sound simulation. Then we have to take care that the two parts of the object are in bilateral energetic consistency. This means that we have to implement an archetypal model in which the whole action sound chain is modeled as two interacting closed loop systems as proposed by complex system modeling. Okay, that's the model. I cannot explain this, but you will see and hear now this type of implementation, and you will notice that in this example. There are timbre changing, there are this type of phenomena that you sound in the glass. That is the possible device.
Okay.
both the string and the finger on the glass, and he noticed the changing of the timbre. Not on the pitch, the same on the pitch. And the timbre. And we have another type of parameter. Another visual representation, or nice representation, and we use in
like this type of movement. It's just an unstable state at the end of the sequence.
Instrumentalist, in the time, and the microscope,
currently linked with the macroevolution. This means that there is an energetic and dynamic consistency between the structure, the musical structure, the structure of the sounds and the macro structures of the evolution. It is the same as in the sound process. Macroscopic auto-organization as well as the evolution come from the microstructure and vice versa. Or, as in Bella Vortices, the phenomena that appear at our human scale is under two conditions, two very different scales of interacting phenomena, a big scale and a small scale, and the ratio between the scales is very good. And this could be a model of a group of human surroundings. We assume that the psychophysical phenomena that are playing in a group of instrumentalists can be results of comparable processes having this kind of properties. Several other examples of evolving structure, macroscopic evolution linked with microstructure, wind evolution. This shows the property that is involved.
It is made the same idea. There is one object that is simulated, it is a very simple model, but this object is calculated so you can use it at small scale, overall small scale, and large spatial scale, and it is possible. And it is manipulated to pass feedback to the pass feedback to the parts. And look at here what happens. I don't know if you see where the
thank you.
represent boreal aurora. The effect is not the same, but the model I design is inspired by this type of physical phenomena. I modeled a string that is triggered by a non-linear realization system on the door. And this represents the fact that energy is accumulated in accumulated and after that restricted locally. And this string, this string is coupled with a wide deformable space, and this gives this energy.
For example, the avalanche of the
success in our appraisal, or in the mastering of such phenomena, that we are able to know intuitively and immediately. We need a long, long, long physically based learning, physical learning. That is, of course, the same long, this learning is as long as the learning you have to understand formally the phenomena by physics, for example. I don't know if you understand what I mean. It is a way for the humans to understand more, but with our body, what this type of phenomena, what it happens in the nature. In fact, we have two ways, simultaneous ways to masterize or to understand this type of things. The formal learning, such as in physics, and the instrumental learning, such as in manipulating of objects, such as, for example, as it is well illustrated, that is an exemplary case, the musical learning or the painting learning, if you want to say, when you manipulate pastels on a surface, that is the same kind of phenomenon. We can enlarge this issue to, for example, the mixing of color through the manipulation of pastels and this type of thing. It is quite complex. And we learn this, and we need to learn this. Okay, I don't know if I answered your question. And this means that when we understand, when we are in front of the result, this process, immediately, from our ontological evolution and from the social knowledge represented by learning, we are able to immediately be in front of the problem. Yes. I am in front of, okay, this long learning of these things. I am not able to do this. For example, the course said, I am not able to do this because I didn't learn. I don't have sufficient learning, etc. This is this kind of thing we have in mind and in our body. When we are in front of a success, for example, a success in painting, a success in playing a musical instrument, a success in... I think that is this threshold point. And with this, nothing can appear.
So it's more on the process of producing the world of art than in cracking the world of art. So I can accept the fact in the process to produce the world of art. Right. And deal with the capability, and at the end there is the result. But the complexity of an existing world of art is the interaction to gain more depth of this complexity is something different than interpretability. The emotion that we feel when we deal with a particular phenomenon is one thing, not necessarily having to do with the world of art. Unless you intend that the process to produce the world of art is a physics, the impenetrability, then I might agree. Not that a new definition of the world of art is something that has to be impenetrable. So it's a only question of semantics. The world of art is.
For me, but the threshold I spoke is that when we look some things, for example, or when we hear something, we are able to compare. We synthesize a similar bone swing sound put on a mobile phone. Probably the effect for you not the same than in front of the sound produced really by the boat that is the street that is boat. Because in the final end, if you remove the very small signs that indicate that it is a trace or an engraving of a struggle between a human and the nature, the emotion doesn't appear. I think the emotion is also a effect if you want, such as okay? And the condition trigger this emotion is inside the production process, but the production process produces it, and this relevant feature playing in the production process are visible, understandable in the event produced. If you erase this in the event produced, you don't understand nothing, and there is no emotion, artistic emotion. You are in front of something, okay, but why not? Okay, that is the idea of a different. Sorry, no?
Sorry, I'm not going to time to speak. I'd just like to ask you about your use of the word evolution. We can use this word in at least two senses. One is a general development, which is clearly what you're showing, that the sound of development and so on. But you can also use this in a more precise term in terms of longer-term cyclical development, whereby the actual fundamental rules, for example, in the system that you're using change. And first, it's obviously using it in the first sense, but I wondered if to what extent you had used or had experimented in the other sense, of having systems which every time you land them actually move their starting point or transition rules in some way.
The system is not evolving. The system that produces the sound, this is the sound or the phenomena that is evolving naturally because the system exhibits a wide number of states. Intrinsically. It is the sound that is evolving, not the system. It is also possible, but I don't have an example here, it is also possible to implement with physically based on a particle system that are evolving, systems, not. And it is possible to compare. I don't show. It is possible to compare. This type of process is that the system, based on the systems we understand as the component, such as the Recherche network, for example. And it's possible to compare this what I call the internet network to a known network and to a general based network, in which we can implement explicitly the evolution of the system. But in the example I showed, there is no modification or no evolution of the structure itself that produces the phenomenon.
In fact, my question was also related to that in terms of learning. If there is any sense, but meaningful sense, in which you can say that your simulations learn in the way that the college learns, that fine tuning that you are.
The system, which is the model of the wind energy, doesn't implement the learning capabilities in terms of the system, okay? It is possible, it is possible. It is an interesting problem. We have the PhD thesis, and the two PhD thesis on this topic, for example, is it possible to design automatically the model to produce the wine for the observed phenomena? Yes, it is possible. I don't know if it is general, but in two cases we did this. But the other idea is when we have in front of a phenomena that is evolving, we have to decide if the evolution is necessarily produced by the evolution of the system or by the complexity of the system itself. This example is a little provocative because I want to show that it is not necessary to implement the evolution of the system itself. But to implement a sufficient level of complexity, even if the model is very simple, for example, the scale. The two scales in the model, very simple nonlinear interactions, but just sufficient. This is a kind of difficulty in designing this type of model, but it is possible to provide evolution that could be also produced by
your example with and for the new chair, which was at the very start, we'll get into their questions. I didn't quite understand it.
The sound isn't.
The sound example, yes. When you just play the text, then the Grenoble is very true, but I get true that the text is very true. But in this example, you showed for music, or you produced music for the role of the universe. Where does this come
from?
I think we're referring to some physiological reasons, which is quite different.
Thank you.